One mistake I see a lot of amateur designers make is alternating the colors on every section of their website. This gives your websites kind of a stripey look and it's not very pleasing to the eye. So in this video, I'm going to show you a few tips and tricks to help you avoid that stripey look and polish up your designs. If that sounds like something that's interesting to you, then stick around and let's get started. Okay, so what we got here is a pretty nice design, but you can see that there is some stripiness going on. So here in the hero, we can see we have a little bit of a darker background. In the next section, we have a pure white background. Then we go into a gray followed by a white, and you can see it's just kind of alternating as we go throughout each section of this website. And the nice thing about doing some kind of stripes like this is it does put some separation in between each one of your sections. But for me, this gets a little bit repetitive, and I think there's a way we can keep that separation in between sections without looking stripey. So let's go ahead and start that by using our first tactic, which is overlapping content. To do this, I'm gonna go ahead and make a copy of this design here so we have two side by side to look at. And I'm just gonna grab this second section here and I'm gonna bring this content up so that it overlaps the hero section here. I've just kind of mimicked the amount of padding around these pictures here. So you can see now this image inside this section is overlapping the section above it. We still have some nice separation here between the hero and the next section, but they actually feel a little bit more tied together now that they overlap. We can tell when we zoom out of this a little bit and look at these two sections side by side, the one on the right just starts to look a little bit more cohesive. Now, you can have a problem of things getting too busy when you do this. Obviously, this background image I have is a little bit faded out, so there's not too much busyness going on here. And you might even argue that this is a little bit busy for this design, but I do think overlapping content can help break up some of the stripiness. You can see in this one, we have a hard line going all the way across, and here that line is kind of broken up by these images, so it's less apparent that this has a hard line all the way in between the two sections. The next trick I like to use a lot, especially in sections like this where these two layouts are fairly similar, you can see these bottom parts have just kind of been reversed. I want to give some kind of separation in between these two things, but I don't want a full background stop, like a hard stop in between both of them. So I'm just going to go ahead and grab this background color here and get rid of it. Now I almost feel like all of this runs together too much, but what I can do is just create some kind of simple gradient that helps bring some distinction in between each one of the sections. So you can do this just as simple as drawing a shape. This is what I will often do, is maybe just grab my pen tool here and I'm gonna drag a little curve and maybe have it curve out to here. And then I'll go back and close this shape. We'll go ahead and mark that done. We'll take off the stroke and add a fill here. Now for the fill, I actually wanna use a gradient because I don't wanna see this hard line down here at the bottom. So I'm gonna change this dark color here to white, which is essentially just to match the background I have in the rest of this section. And as far as this top color, we can go with this gray I already have. I think that might be a little bit dark, so I'm gonna raise it up just a little bit. Hopefully you can still see that through the screen share okay. And we'll take this to the back here. That way it's back behind the image. So now we can play around with this gradient a little bit. I want to make sure that I come up a little bit off the edge so you never see that hard line at the bottom. And often I'll want to kind of angle it so you can see that it's kind of fading. It might be hard to tell on the screen share, but if we zoom in a little bit here, I can grab this point here and you can see that that white is kind of fading here at this top area. So I kind of play around with that. It's helpful to zoom out and kind of see where it might make sense. And I might bring it to something like that. But now we're still seeing this hard line at the bottom, so I know I want to bring it up a little bit higher. And just about there, we can see that hard line disappear where this shape is almost just fading into the background. And up here, you can see it's getting a little bit lighter over to the side. So I'll go ahead and close that. I think this is maybe too sharp of a curve. And, you know, we just grabbed the pen tool and drew a random shape. So I'm going to stretch it out a little bit, and I think that fits the space a little bit better. So I'm gonna take this same shape here and duplicate it. And I'm gonna go here and flip this horizontally. And we're gonna put it on this next section here. So we kind of have a matching motif going down this page. We can see in this section here, we have the shape coming off from the right-hand side. And here we have it coming off from the left. And now if we zoom out and look at these two sections, we can see there's still some separation that's created by these shapes and this gradient. So we can tell these are two different pieces of content, two different parts of the website, but we don't have a hard line in between them and a solid background like we do on this section here. Here, everything flows a little bit nicer while still giving us a little bit of distinction. Of course, shapes and gradients, that's just one example of a way we can do this. I'll often use simple lines to break up information. Let's try that down here on this testimonial section. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the background here. And if I turn on my rulers, you can see that I have this content area set here for these top sections. These ones are a little bit more narrow, but this testimonial one's even more narrow than that. Obviously, I don't want this text to be super wide, so I have this brought in a bit. So this actually gives us a little bit of room to play around. What I'm going to do is go ahead and grab my line tool here, and I'm going to draw a line right on the edge of this container box, maybe just to the bottom of that profile image. Go ahead and get rid of those guides again, and we can see we just have a solid line here. I think what I'll do to change that up is just grab my eyedropper tool and maybe grab the same dark gray color we used in our gradient earlier. We might have to go a bit darker than that just because I know it's hard to see on the screen. So I'll just grab a slightly darker color and you should be able to see that. Now, a solid line doesn't look great for me here, but what we can do is go in here to our stroke style and change this to a dashed line. And maybe I go with, I don't know, 10 on the dash and 2 on the gap. And we can see we kind of have a dotted line there. Now that creates some separation here from the side, but I think we need to create separation from the top. So what I'm gonna do is just copy this entire little line and I'm gonna rotate it 90 degrees. Now maybe we go up here and we bring this all the way over to the side, line it up with our guides over here. I don't like the way they kind of connect here on the side. So what I think I'll do is just bring these out a little bit further and make them kind of extend beyond their container here. And we can see we've created some separation between this section here and this testimonial without having to get a really stark contrast of changing the background color. But if we zoom out here, we can see this style here is something I really prefer when we're not trying to call a ton of attention. It's not like this testimonial is a big call to action. We want to make sure that everybody stops down and sees this section. This is just another part of this page, and I think these little dashes give us some separation from the other content without being too dramatic like we see with the stripy look on the left-hand side. But now that we kind of created this motif of these dashed lines, I think we should reuse that on the page so it looks more purposeful instead of kind of an accident or something that it just appears in one section. So I'm going to go ahead and grab this horizontal line and copy it. I'm going to move up here to our section here and go ahead and paste this in. Now I'm just going to move this around to get it kind of positioned here. What I'm trying to do is create some separation between the second section here and down here, even though I do need to play with that spacing a bit. We'll go ahead and move this backwards so it's back behind that picture. And then we can line it up over here on the left-hand side and make sure it's not peeking out on the right-hand side there. Now we might bring that down a little bit just to kind of even out the space in between here and up here. In fact, it might need to go down just a little bit further. I'm just trying to even out the amount of space above this heading here and below this text here. And this little separator here helps draw a little bit of a distinction between this section of content here and this section of content here. But let me go ahead and move all this up since we've created a little bit of extra space. I think our spacing's just a tad off. I'm just going to eyeball this for now, but you probably would want to use some kind of spacing system to make sure it's consistent throughout the entire site. But here, if we see these two sections now side by side, we're using the overlapping content to kind of bring together the second section and the hero. And then we're using this dashed line and this little shape with a gradient to create some separation between these two sections here. If you give me a choice between what's on the left and what's on the right, I'm going to go with something on the right just about every time. Like I said, there are exceptions to this rule, and you don't want every section to run into another without some kind of break. But in a case like this, I really don't need to create any kind of stop on this page at this point. I'm trying to get people to read down further and further and scroll through the page. And I think this actually helps achieve that quite a bit better than what you see over on the left. And now that we've gotten rid of so much of the stripiness, this top bar above the menu is bothering me as well. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that background color. Now, these kind of run into each other. So again, I think we could use something like a line in here. I'll go ahead and just draw a line that matches our content width. And we'll make sure to change this color to the color from our palette. And that works fine, but I think in this case, we'd actually want to take this stripe and put it all the way to the edge of the page. Now here we're able to create some separation between this pre-header menu and the actual header itself, but we didn't do that with a full color background like we did over on the side. We did it by just giving it a slight border in between the two. And again, looking at these two side by side, I think this one on the right just creates a much better look. Now the last tip I want to share with you are these full width sections. This is something if I'm running into a situation where the entire site or an entire page is looking kind of stripey, this is one of those things I will try to use. Now this doesn't work in every design, but when it works, it actually works quite well. I'm gonna go ahead and drop my rulers on again, and you can see I have this outer ruler way out on the edge of the page. I'm gonna go ahead and grab this hero section, and I'm gonna bring in both sides to match this rule we have out here, this guideline we have. And essentially what I'm doing is just pulling this full width section slightly away from the edge. I'm giving it some margin around it. Now, when I do this here in this design, I probably want to match this border radius from this image here on my hero. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on my hero and give it 12 pixels of border radius to match. Now, something like this helps keep this hero section from looking stripey. It has some distinction between the header just because it has a background image, but it's not completely cut off from it. It almost looks as if there's room to get around it. And I know we're not actually trying to move around this space, but it helps just keep the page from being broken up into too many sections. Now that we did this up in the hero, I might want to go down into my footer and do the same thing as well. So I'll bring back my guides and we'll bring that into the edge. Now I need to match that border radius here on the top of this call to action section and at the bottom of my footer here. So we'll go ahead and put those 12 pixels in. We'll remove those guidelines again. And you can see just the edge of our page has a little bit of margin in between these sections. Now let's go ahead and zoom out and look at this entire page here. You can see the one on the left, we have our original stripey design, and this one will change to non-stripey. Now I've pretty much gotten rid of every stripe on this page, and I'm not saying you can never use a stripe, but I just wanted to kind of show how all these examples work. The one on the right is actually what I've used in this design, or at least something close to it. I didn't want any of those stripes for these particular sections. And for me, this design on the right just flows a bit nicer. Now, like I said before, this isn't any kind of strict rule where you can never use a hard line across any of your designs. However, using them too often creates this stripey effect, and I think you could see in this video in our side-by-side comparison that avoiding that does improve the look and feel of your designs. And I'm very sorry that I've ruined it for you forever, because every time you see a stripey website from now on, you're gonna think of this video. Hopefully you learned a few new tips and tricks in today's video. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up. And if you wanna make sure to catch the next video, hit subscribe and we'll see you then.